Hello, Mr. Nygren here. So we're playing Super Smash Bros. But it's Smash REMIX for the Project 64 emulator for the computer. So this is the original Super Smash Bros. Game from 1999, but it's a modified version. So they modified the American ROM of the game. So it's played on the computer. Of course, all these modifications wouldn't have fit on the limited space of a N64 I forgot the word, but the Nintendo 64, the Super Nintendo, and the Nintendo 8, Nintendo 8-bit consoles, they were, as you say, they used cartridges and not CDs, so there were limited space. Okay, so this is a ROM on the computer, and it's been modified. It's adding 12 new characters and many new stages, while still being based on the original game, so it will play like the original. So they add the characters from later games to this game. So we can play one play mode or VS mode. Go for one play mode. I used to be very good at playing Link in this game, Adult Link. There are new game modes, REMIX modes. We have REMIX one player, All Star mode, Multi-Man mode, and Cruel Multi-Man mode. I have never played any of these. The training mode, one player game. Let's just go for training mode. So we can try out some moves with the new characters. So as we can see, it's the original Super Smash Bros. Game, but with new characters. I managed to click back there, backwards. Okay, so we have new characters. So an old character, I believe Dr. Mario was in the old game. Maybe he was in Melee and not in the original Nintendo 64 game. It's been a while, but I think he was in Melee as a secret character. Now he's been added to the modified version of the original game. Luigi was a secret character in the original. Mario was one of the starting characters. Donkey Kong was also one of the starting characters. Adult Link was one of the starting characters. By the way, in this REMIX mod, you can also choose to play with English voices or Japanese voices. Adult Link was in the original. I was very good with him. I believe I could defeat three other players if they were in a team against me, and I played with Link. I could defeat all three of them, and also I could defeat level 9 computers, of course, as well. Three versus me. But that was when I was young. So when I got a when I got a Nintendo 64 on my 10th birthday, the game Super Smash Bros. Or Super Smash Brothers followed with the console. So I had this game on the original Nintendo 64 back in 1999, and maybe up until 21 or something, when I got a PlayStation 2 and a Nintendo GameCube instead. I sold my Nintendo 64 to my sister, but yeah, I had this game and I used to play it a lot with friends, but also alone. So I played a lot with friends, and they used to come over and play. We used to play, I believe, I only had two controllers, so we could only play two at a time versus two computers, or two at a time against both the player and the computers, you know, the free-for-all mode. But I didn't have four controllers. Maybe sometimes they brought over some of their controllers so we could play four, but most of the time I believe we were two playing and then two computers. Okay, and this mod is of course played on the computer, but I have a Nintendo 64 controller connected to the computer through a I believe, a device that I connected to. Then I connect the device to the computer through the USB ports. So I am using a Nintendo 64 controller now. Of course I only have one, I'm playing with the original N64 controller. And this mod adds a bunch of new characters. We have Samus, she was in the original as well. We have Captain Falcon, original character. I think he was a secret character that you had to unlock. We have a new character here, Ganondorf. He arrived in the 21 Super Smash Bros. Melee game. I also had that one. Played it to the finish, played it a lot. Both with friends and alone. My favorite character was Mewtwo, but I also like Ganondorf. Of course Link, my favorite in the first game, was also a favorite in the second game, but I believe he was nerfed compared to the first game. He wasn't as good. He had some new attacks and lost some of his old ones, I believe. Okay, so Ganondorf in this mod looks a lot like Ganondorf from the Ocarina of Time game. Okay, we have Falco from the Star Fox series, or Starving series. I had Starving for the Super Nintendo, by the way. And I had Lylat Wars for Nintendo 64. Okay, Jigglypuff was one of the secret characters. Pokemon and Falco is a new character in this mod. Pikachu was one of the original characters. Fox was one of the originals. Kirby was one of the originals. Yoshi as well. And Ness, I believe, was the fourth and final secret character of the original game. Then we have Young Link. He was introduced in Melee and has now been added to this game. And we have Dark Samus. I believe Dark Samus has never been in any other Smash game, but I saw a mod that had him. Okay, a mod for Super Smash Bros. Brawl for the Nintendo Wii. Then we have Wario. He was added, I believe, in either Brawl or Melee. We have Lucas. Same there. He was added in Melee or in Brawl. We have Bowser added in Melee. Even though the Bowser in Melee was very big, and then he got reduced in size in Brawl, I believe. Wolf, the evil guy from the Star Fox series. We have Conker, another character. I never played this game, but I recognize him as one of the main character. Excuse me, main characters from one of the platformers of the 90s, I believe. We have Mewtwo, my favorite Pokemon character. When I was into Pokemon as a kid, I was 10 years old in 1999, when Pokemon was huge, and Mewtwo, of course, being the big bad villain, of course, was my favorite, the strongest one also at the time. I know there are a lot of Pokemon since then. I believe in 1999 there were 151 Pokemon. Then there came the second generation and the third generation. And I stopped being interested in Pokemon after the third generation came. So I saw the third Pokemon movie with Entei and such, and then I lost interest. However, I did watch some of the movies many years later when I got interested in watching them for nostalgia's sake. So I have seen, I believe, some movies after the third one. I watched one with Celebi that was actually pretty good, and then I watched some others too. I mean, I seem to remember Mewtwo's Return, and then there were some others, but I haven't seen all of them. Okay, I've seen all of the movies with the old art style, the ones that looked like in the first and second seasons. I haven't really watched the ones from when they changed the art style of the show. Okay, and then in the show I saw the entire first season as a kid. I used to record every Saturday, I believe, and Sunday morning. I never saw season 2 and 3. However, a year ago or something, believe I saw some of the episodes of season 2. But I don't really think the Pokemon anime is that interesting. It's way too childish and yeah, it's kinda cringe worthy to watch it as an adult. But yeah, I saw some of the episodes of season 2 a year ago or something, just out of curiosity. But I believe they changed the art style after season 3, and season 3 ended in the middle of the season in Sweden, so we never got any seasons after season 3. I believe we got the first few episodes of season 3 and then it stopped. But the first season I watched on TV. Okay, and then we have Marth here too. I believe they have the same attacks as in Melee and Brawl. Strike Ganondorf. Then we have probably new stages too, and some old ones. This one is old, Peach's castle. So Peach wasn't in the game, but her castle was there. Okay, and then we have Yoshi's Island. Old stage, we have Dragon King, this is a new stage, we have Mini Yoshi's Island, so I believe one of them is old and one of them is an altered version. I don't know which one is the old one, maybe the Mini Yoshi's Island is the new one. Then we have Dreamland, an old stage, we have Congo Jungle, another old one, we have Hyrule Castle, one of the favorites when I was a child. And it's old, of course. We have Sector C, Starwing, Lilith Wars, also one of the favorites. We have First Destination from the intro of the game. I never believed that this was an actual stage in the game. So that's a new stage. And we have the Showdown, it's a new stage. We have Saffron City from the Pokemon franchise. It's an old stage. We have Planet Seeps from the Metroid franchise. It's old. And we have Mushroom Kingdom. I believe that's a new stage. We have Dual Zone. Might have been in the game as a boss fight or something, but I don't know. Or it's a new stage. We have Battlefield. It's new. Final Destination. That's the fight with the hand, so that's the boss fight. Metacrystal, I believe that's the stage where you fight a lot of metal Marios and such. So it's in the game, but it wasn't selectable, I believe, in the original. So we took Ganondorf, so we will play on Hyrule Castle, the only Zelda stage in the original and in this mod. So I do, by the way, own. So I used to own a Nintendo 64, and then in 2021 I got the Nintendo GameCube. So I played both the Super Smash Bros. For N64 and Super Smash Bros. Melee for the Nintendo GameCube. Then in 2006 the Nintendo Wii was released, and I bought it in 2008. Of course, the first game I bought was Super Smash Bros. Brawl. I used to own between 2008 and 2011 when I sold the console because I wanted a dog, a pet. Okay, and yeah, that was a mistake and resulted in me not having the console for many years, but I bought a new Nintendo Wii, a shipped version. By the way, my old one was shipped. I believe we shipped it. It was a legal console. It was legal when I bought it in the store, but then I believe we shipped it. But it was a PAL console, so it couldn't run Super Smash Brothers with mods. Because if you want to play Super Smash Bros. With mods on the Nintendo Wii, you either need to use the hackless method or you need an American Nintendo Wii and the American Super Smash Brothers game. And I had the PAL version of the game and of the console. I had bought the game too. Okay, so mods didn't work on my old Nintendo Wii. But I bought another one in 2018, I believe, that was shipped, but it was also a PAL console, so it couldn't run the modified version of the game like I had hoped. That's when I read up on it and realized they needed the American version. So I actually bought the American version in 2020 from eBay, and I have a Nintendo Wii from America with the Super Smash Brothers game from America, and the mods work on it. So I am actually in the process of trying out a bunch of Super Smash Brothers Brawl mods, but then I found a mod that was unreleased called Smash 1 for Nintendo Wii, which turns Super Smash Brothers Brawl into the N64 game, but with additions like new characters and such. When I searched for that game on YouTube, found this game in one of the videos, similar game, but unlike the other one, it was released and was not a mod for the Nintendo Wii, and was instead a mod for the original Nintendo 64. But this one, unfortunately, is not played on the N64, because it is using cartridges, as I said, and it would be impossible to fit the new stuff on the cartridge. But the mods for Nintendo Wii, they are actually played on the console, so to speak. So that's the difference. But you can also use a Dolphin emulator, which I will probably do if I am ever going to record when I play them. Okay, let's take Hyrule Castle. So I picked Ganondorf. So the problem in this game is we cannot zoom in on the character like in later games. We can walk. We can run. Double jump. Two buttons. Still has Captain Falcon's attacks. I had preferred if he had, you know, the Mage Ganondorf attacks from the Brawl mods, but I realized they want to be probably close to the melee game, the official game, where Ganondorf unfortunately didn't have any unique attacks and only was a clone. His attacks were a clone of Captain Falcon, but I believe he was slightly slower and had some stronger attacks. But they were the same moves, but he was stronger than Captain Falcon and slower, but had the very same moves. And a mod for Super Smash Bros. Brawl gave Ganondorf completely new attacks instead. It made him more like he is in the boss battle in Ocarina of Time, where he flies and casts spells at Link and such. So he's more unique in that mode. So I can bring forth my staff like this. Okay. Oh, I can pose too. Let's place him on attack. Get some opposition in the training mode. Hey! close up to him. That's cool. Didn't know we could that in the original. Maybe this is a new feature. Now that in melee and brawl you can zoom in when you pause the game. It's annoying to fight like this, of course. But you get some clear pictures of the character. Could be nice when you are in the bonus stages and just want to take a look at the character. I always thought Ganondorf looked kinda cool in the original N64 game. Okay, let's return that and exit. And return from training. Single player game. To the original game. I always used to play Link. And I used to play the blue version of Link. I don't see. I don't know why I can change the shrine of the character like this. Okay, that's the best look, and then I used to always play blue Link for some reason. Black Link didn't exist. Yellow Link didn't exist either, I think. We had green Link, we had this purple Link, we had red Link, and we had blue Link. We have 4 variations. So anything else is new. And I used to play on. I believe I could have all the stocks, but to get the secret characters, I believe I needed to use only 3 lives and play on normal, hard, or very hard. So I'm more interested in playing one of the new characters. We could try Ganondorf. I will have maximum health because I haven't played in a while. Very easy, maybe not. We'll play on normal. They even have the announcer saying the name. Cool. Wait a second. So when I zoom in this mode, I can actually zoom in on the character like this and move around, just like in the melee game and brawl games, where I can also take photos. I don't think I can that in this game. But at least I get some close-ups on Ganondorf here. Yeah. They probably used the same Ganondorf from the original game, Ocarina of Time game. Used the model from that game, I think so. Okay, so this is Ganondorf. We will have to defeat the Hero of Time, Link. I always thought it was kinda boring that he didn't have any new attacks and only was like a better clone of Captain Falcon. But I still like that they included Ganondorf. I always wanted them to include Nibiru too, the female Gerudo girl from the Green game. Can't allow the enemy to have that. He almost got wrecked by that bomb. So I played this game a million times as a kid, alone, but also with friends. It was the only game I had on the Nintendo 64 for quite a while. And then later I got new games like Pokémon Stadium, Violet Wars, James Bond, GoldenEye. But James Bond I wasn't allowed to own for for a long time because it was for age restricted, 15 years. And I were like 10 when I got the console. But I believe I still got that game when I was 11 or something. My parents weren't willing to let me play games that were restricted. For some reason I managed to somehow get the James Bond game after a while. But I remember when my friends in like, there were some friends back in like, when I was six I believe, or seven, that had that James Bond game and I wasn't allowed to play it. But as an 11 year old I believe I finally got to play it. Okay, and it's really good too. I have many memories of playing it with my sister and friends. You know, 4-player with the screen divided into 4, like quarters. 4 split screen, where everyone played on the same screen. It was very fun. To rig stages with mines and exploding when the others went by. But this game was probably my favorite. Okay, so we are facing Fox now. Starving for Lilith Wars. I have many memories of playing on this stage too. It's very good, this stage, when fighting with others. When playing with others, I used to chicken down here while the others fought on the, like, above this wing here. Then when they had reduced their health, I would it's a classic stage. So we won. Break the target. There. Can't attack like that, I see. Fuck! I fucked up that one. We aren't very good at these stages. Probably finish them at one point or so, because I believe some of the secret characters needed you to finish those stages, but never really liked those bonus stages. Okay, so we're allied with Samus now and are fighting the Mario Brothers. Okay. By the way, I installed the latest version of Project 64, the Nintendo 64 emulator, today. I had the 2. something, 2.23 or something version. Fuck, we died. I fucked up. Didn't pay attention. But anyway, we had the 2.3.2 or something version, and now we have a version 3 point something. The new version was released recently. This mod didn't work on the old one. That's why I looked up if there was a new one, and then I found one and it worked. So. The Pikachu stage, I always found it kinda annoying, because creatures, Pokemon, would come out from that door there to the right and attack you time to time, like that Porygon there. I'm surprised they have a Porygon in the game, by the way. That Pokemon was, I believe, banned from the anime because of some incident where people got sick watching it. When watching the episode on TV, they got sick because of all the colors from the Pokemon. So it got banned, but it is in this game, but I've seen it in other games too. It wasn't allowed to be in the anime after that incident. I don't remember how I throw stuff in this game. Let's die already. So we lost one life in the previous stage. Kinda immortal in the beginning there. They didn't take any damage. Ah, they are my allies. Only Donkey Kong is the enemy. It's a giant version of Donkey Kong. He isn't that big in normal battles, only in this stage, because he's a boss here. You're fighting with Yoshi and Mario to take down a guy in Donkey Kong. Forgot. Okay. We're playing the original story mode now, but with the new character Ganondorf. We'll try the new story mode of the mode later. Okay. Border platforms. This might be easier than the other one. Sorry, I spoke in Swedish, but I fucked up there, I messed up. Okay, let's see here, we need to go this way. Let's see. Oh, fuck. How will we do this? I don't know. So I think we need to... Ah, fuck. We needed to somehow jump there and somehow jump up. Maybe we should have come from the other side, I don't know. Anyway, we failed. Fuck! I almost fucked up there. Ah, we're fighting many Kirbys, and they have Swallowed, Samus, and Link, so they have some of their attacks. Samus one can fire blasts, and the Link one, I don't know. Let's die already. Fuck, that wasn't good. throw that Pokeballs, we got hit in the air. Fuck, don't be allowed to die. Just die already. Good, game set. So we're facing Samsaran now. This stage, the lava. Never played the Samus games, the Metroid games, where she is the main character. I did, however, try the Super Metroid game for the Super Nintendo when I visited a friend like a year ago. But no, I haven't really played the old games back in the day. I also own Metroid Prime. The Nintendo GameCube had a Japanese Nintendo GameCube between 2008 and 2011. I also sold that one when I wanted that dog, as I said, and with the Wii, and what can I say, I had a lot of games for it. I had Zelda Twilight Princess, I had Metroid Prime, I had Resident Evil 1, 2 and 3, among other games, and all of them got sold to get that dog together with Nintendo Wii. But anyway, Metroid Prime is like a first-person shooter game with Samus as the main character, while Super Metroid is like the new game, the Metroid Dread game, where you are more like playing traditional platformer, but it's a difficult platformer actually. And I never really liked that type of game, where you have a hard time knowing how to progress. I liked platformers like Donkey Kong and Donkey Kong Country and Super Mario, but never really liked the harder ones like Castlevania and Metroid Prime. I never tried Metroid Prime when I was a kid. But when I tried it, I thought it was kinda boring. Maybe I would have liked it as a kid, because back then I had way more patience back as a kid. I mean, even Donkey Kong Country can be annoying today. I believe I tried it too, a year ago, at that friend's house, and I weren't very good, so I lost interest very fast. In the past, you know, you had almost no other choices. You had the games that your parents bought and nothing else. So you had to do with what they gave you, and if it was difficult, you had to try and try and try again and again and again until you finally made it. So back then I had almost done, I believe, limitless patience finishing games like this, but as an adult, I don't really have much patience at all. I believe we are about to... we should run, I believe. We'll before the timer runs out. Supposed to run, but sometimes the controller is a little bit slow reacting when I use the direction button. When I use the rotation button, I don't know the name. Okay, so now we're fighting all the polygons. Okay. So this was the stage before the boss, I see. So it was an old stage after all, just not selectable when you played multiplayer in the original game. So they have made a lot of stages playable that were only in story mode, where you couldn't really fight in the original. Good. Fuck, he died again. He fucked up. A bomb exploded. I didn't see it, so I attacked it. Fuck, he died again because I didn't know where I were. The screen, I lost sight of my actual character. Guys, I won't reach the boss without having to continue, but it's fine, it's been ages since I played this game. By the way, I played the Dragon Ball beta of a Smash game for Nintendo Wii, Dragon Ball Z Brawl. It was really good. It had too few characters, anyway, I guess. The only bad thing was that it had few characters. It had new characters like Vegeta, Goku, Frieza, Gotenks, Son Gohan as a kid, I mean as a teen. Not a kid, but teen. And it had lost now. Okay, so you'll have to click retry or continue, yes. Okay, so the game had a lot of it had new skills for every character, except Piccolo because it was unfinished. So Piccolo still used some, I believe, Ganondorf moves or Captain Falcon moves, but everyone else had new the moves. And I really liked Vegeta in that game, he was really good. So I have played some other official games that are like Super Smash Brothers. For one, we had a game that was named D.U.N. Stars or something. And in that game, you fought like in Super Smash Bros. Brawl, yes. It's for the GameCube and for the PlayStation 2. Maybe it's more like Lee or Melee, but in that game you could fight on stages from Naruto, One Piece, and Dragon Ball Z. You can use characters from those games too, but there were very few characters, only the main characters. So it lacked a bunch of characters that you would want. And also, it wasn't very fun because I believe that the main problem with the game was that you couldn't play with stock like I do now. You know, you couldn't play with lives, so you only had the option to play with time. And the other thing was that you lacked most of the items here. You had other items, of course, from the Dragon Ball universe, but it wasn't as fun. And then, also, the main problem was that you were forced to play I believe there was a meter. It wasn't a timer, it was a meter at the top of the screen. Whenever the meter were reduced for one side, you lost the game. No matter if... maybe you picked two characters, and then whenever that meter was reduced, you lost, even if one of the characters was still alive. Or it was that meter... Yeah, I think so. You could play four players at once, of course, like in this game. But whenever that meter, if you played a team, 2v2, whenever the meter was reduced on one side, you would lose, even if one of your characters were still alive. So it kinda ruined the game, because it wasn't like Super Smash Bros. Melee and Super Smash Bros. etc. How it worked when it came to life meter and such. It would have been better if it had been an exact copy of this game and not different. Anyway, if it had been exactly like this when it came to how characters die and such, but it wasn't. Then I played a Ninja Turtles game too, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game that was like this. That game was actually pretty good, and similar to Smash Brothers, I believe. But had too few characters, and then played a Full Metal Alchemist game named Dream Carnival. It was like Super Smash Brothers 2. And it's very fun too. Has enough characters, but it's a little bit different than Super Smash Brothers in how you lose attacks and such. You can play 4 players. And it has team modes and all that, and items. But it allows you to do super attacks and such that you can't do in the original Smash Brothers and in Melee. I believe in Brawl you can if you get a certain item. But in that game, all the characters had their own unique supers, which was kind of cool. But I still think that Super Smash Brothers was the best one. No, none of the others came close. The Turtles game was the one, I believe, that was the most like Super Smash Brothers. The DUN game with Dragon Ball Z, One Piece and Naruto characters were very much like Super Smash Brothers when it came to how you select characters and how the stages look and such, but the life system was completely different, and that's what ruined the game. Another thing that ruined it was that they had very few characters, only the basic characters. For example, for Naruto that would be Sasuke, Sakura, Kakashi and Naruto himself. For One Piece it would be Luffy, Sanji, Nami and Zoro, maybe Usopp as well. No villains. None of the villains were playable, or side characters. So that's kinda disappointing there. Dragon Ball characters were fine, you had like some villains too. You had Goku, you had Vegeta, then you had Frieza, and you had Cell. And you had Majin Buu, I think. So the Dragon Ball roster was pretty good. They just lacked Android 18 in the roster. As for the other factions, like the Naruto and the One Piece characters, I believe, I wanted some villains, but there were no villains from their shows, unfortunately. But the life system sucked anyway. Fuck. Fucked up big time there. We will continue. Yeah, I am not very good in this day and age playing this game. Just playing it for fun, for nostalgia, and because I wanted to try out the new characters that never was in this game. Never were in the game. Ganondorf is completely new for the 64 game. This isn't even a mod. This is a hacked version of the N64 game. A group of hackers have hacked the game and enhanced it. And it's possible because the ROM is on the computer, so then they can use modern tools to edit the files. Wouldn't have been possible to edit the original cartridge, I believe. The ROM is like the game files on the cartridge. You would over to the computer so they can be edited. Okay. The difference with the mod is that with the mod you download the entire mod from the internet, but here you had to download this stuff and then you needed the ROM of the game. And with the ROM of the game you then needed to move it over to the device of the hacking software. I believe I had to move the ROM over to the mod files and then patch it so that it was modified. So it's like requiring the original game. It's not a standalone mod. Oh, I forgot I could use the spear of Ganondorf. Should have used the shield there. Yeah, I really sucked with Ganondorf. I used to be pretty good with him. That's a long time ago. Finally defeated the hand. Master Hand is the name, I think. Okay. This around. When I click on B, I pass it. When I click on A, I can kind of attack it, but nothing seems to happen. Maybe I should just do this. Select all the game staff and game developers. It's been so long time. It's been such a long time since I finished the story mode. First game. So I used to be able to, you know, finish it on the hardest difficulty without any continues. I played with Link and some others, but that's a long time ago, so I've lost my skills, I guess. Screen when we won the game, we can see all the characters. That's cool. Okay, I want to play the single player mode. Link, let's see how I can do. Play like this. Okay, Link versus Link. All right. Let's throw a bomb at the other Link. To hit them for him to start moving. Okay. I have a boomerang we can throw at him too. I used to be very good at hitting the enemy. Now I seem to miss Jesus Christ. Probably looked similar in Green of Time. Okay. Fuck! I fucked up the first battle. I lost. Didn't even lose with Ganondorf the first time. So with Link, I believe we need to be very good at hitting, not missing. We already lost one life, that is. Okay, this will be easier. Can't really fail with this one. Yoshis are not that hard to defeat. At least not on this stage. They're obviously not as good as they would be on a 1v1. These ones are weaker, easy to kill. Fuck, a bomb. I didn't see that. Time. Fuck that. Stole my heart there. I believe the heart only remove percentage that you have taken. You know, when you get hit, the percentage will increase, and when it's really high, you will be easily thrown out of the stage. And I believe the heart only reduces the percentage back to a low percentage again. You can't get back alive if you have lost it, but you will. Kind of lose, reduce the percentage, the damage taken. I sat the entire day and installed mods for Nintendo Wii and tried them out. Then I slept for maybe 4 hours or something. Between 18:30 and 22:00 Swedish time. Yes, we won. Break the targets. Okay. Here we probably need to throw a bomb. Okay. Okay, miss. Can you miss? Yeah, really annoying. Probably missed one. Okay, Link and Donkey Kong versus the Mario Brothers. Fuck! I really messed up here by dying. Shouldn't die on this stage. In the old days when I was actually good at the game, I believe I only ever died in the boss fight or on the metal guys before the boss, because they are pretty hard and they are many. I usually only died on the harder difficulty. If I ever died. Now I kind of feel like an amateur. Okay, so with the baseball racket you can shoot pretty... You can strike very hard at the enemy. Died again because I suck at the game nowadays. I had the same story with Donkey Kong Country. I used to be good at it. Oh, we hurt our own ally with that bomb. One isn't playing constantly, one will lose the skills. Maybe not in Medieval 2. In that game I will probably be good forever. But in Super Smash Brothers, you need to continue to play it or you lose your skills. Fuck! I fucked up again. We probably die before we even get to the boss. There are different Pokemons coming out from this place. Chansey, Porygon, maybe something else. We won, but we still lost, so it doesn't count. Link, Pikachu and Luigi versus Giant Donkey Kong. Jungle, Donkey Kong Country. What the fuck? It's like you lose sight of the character and then he's dead. Take a while until you can get back at the level of skill. I believe I would need to play a lot to get back to my old skills. Because I clearly do not have them anymore. Now we are allied with Samus and Donkey Kong, so the ally is different. I wonder if there are any mods for, let's say, Stadium 1 or 2. I would like to know that. I didn't even know there existed mods for the Nintendo 64 ROM of Super Smash Brothers. It's pretty cool that it does. Really cool mod. I would have loved this mod back as a kid. I was a huge Mewtwo fan, also a huge Ganondorf fan. That's why I loved Melee so much, because it added Ganondorf and Mewtwo. Okay. I was disappointed in Brawl. They removed Mewtwo, but modders added him in again. Then in the later games, Smash 4 and Smash Ultimate, he is back in. But I never owned a Wii U, so I never owned the Smash 4 game. And I do not own a Switch either, so I don't have that game either, the Ultimate game. I thought about getting it, but as I have a lot of mods to play, I don't really need it at the moment. They love that they add Sephiroth, Sora, and King K. Rool from the country, characters I always wanted. No, Sephiroth was my all-time favorite character. Final Fantasy VII is one of my favorite games ever. So, it was the first computer game I ever owned. While Donkey Kong Country was the first console game I ever owned. King K. Rool is the boss there, the evil guy. Then, of course, Sora is the main character of Kingdom Hearts. That was not intended, but I remember failing at this in the past. It wasn't the first time. Never liked the boom stages. What I liked the most about this game was playing against the AI in versus mode and teaming up certain characters with each other, letting them fight against each other. Watching the AI fight each other was fun too, and the best part was playing with friends, of course. It's a very good party game. It's very fun when you were four players and played this game. Or even two players versus the computer. Like was usually the case. I mean, I had my twin sister, so I could play with a lot, and then I had friends too that came over. As I only had two controllers, we could rarely play four players unless they took their controllers to my place, of course. Or I took the game to them. Okay. But this game is a really good game and a really good party game. And when you use Nintendo 64 controllers connected to the computer, it plays exactly like the Nintendo 64. The device I'm using allows two controllers to connect to it, so it's only possible to play two player, not four. The emulator allows four, but I would need a different device to connect four controllers. Or I would need another one, like the one I have, that I bought back in 2009, I believe. Okay, and connect two others to ports for it. I had like master links everywhere back then. But as you see, now I'm an amateur. Didn't even let them touch me. I could defeat 3 level 9 enemies in ES mode alone. And I could also defeat 3 human players, or 2 human players and 1 AI on level 9. And they were all against me if I played Link. But skills do not last forever, I guess. So Link was my original favorite character here. I hadn't even played Zelda game when I played this game. I played the Ocarina of Time, I believe, for the first time on the Nintendo GameCube in 21. I believe a friend had it. So I might have actually played it on the 64, but only very, very little. I didn't really play much of it. I mostly watched him fight, watched him fish on it. You know, you can fish in the game. On this stage you need to avoid the lava. Still I managed to get stuck in it. So we managed to defeat Samus Aran. Metal Mario. A little bit tired, maybe that's why I suck at pronouncing English words this night in this video. Okay, but we'll still play. We wanted to play it. We'll continue until we're done with Link, and then we'll try the new story mode in the remix. We will play as Mewtwo, I believe. Another new character. Probably take me out this time. Yeah. It becomes so bad at this game. I really liked Vegeta in that the Dragon Ball Z mod for Super Smash Bros. Brawl for the Nintendo Wii. He was really, really good. New moves, and they were really, really good. It felt like Vegeta. He was better there than in the official game that I mentioned. But the problem was that it had too few characters. Otherwise it was better than the official game, in the sense that the characters had better moves, and you had all the features of Super Smash Bros. Of course all the stuff in it, items and such, were Nintendo stuff, so it didn't really fit. And then I believe also the stages were Dragon Ball Z stages, and the voices and the music, so it was very good. It had the Budokai Tenkaichi music. He isn't running for some reason. Now he ran. Fuck! Easier to avoid those balls when I play this Ganondorf for some reason. It's running when I click to run to the right. But I believe Ganondorf did run, so I don't know why Link isn't. He's running on to the left, but not to the right. Something wrong. Wait a second. I'm annoyed. Okay. Input configuration. No. Input settings. That should do it, but who knows? It didn't work. I can't run to the right for some reason. I can run to the left, but not to the right. Very weird. Now we are fighting the polygon team. They are actually dangerous. So the ones that could kill me in the original game when I played it as a kid was the Master Hand boss and these guys and the Metal Mario, I believe. Those were the ones I could be taken out by on the very hard difficulty. These guys are easy to kill, but they are many and they take a lot of damage when they hit you. Chance there, that pokeball. Fuck, a bomb killed me. Only one life left. We're lucky there, we hit him with the sword. A fucking bomb there! Fucked up. Continue. We will continue. We failed to win without a continue. I died too much prior to this battle. Okay, fight again. So this is the dual zone stage from Super Smash Bros. Dual stage song from Super Smash Bros. Okay. Okay, that. Oh, fuck, it doesn't work to move to the side, to the right. So that's the problem with using an emulator, that not all buttons work correctly when you configure the controller. Usually let's see here. It's the. I believe the analog stick doesn't work correctly. The right button doesn't work for some reason. Everything else worked. You can walk to the right but using the button, but you cannot run. So it works fine when I use it to speed up and I ran to the left, but for some reason right doesn't work. It worked with Ganondorf, so I don't know if it's a linkish or something. I'll try another character and see if it works again. I fucked up. Let's see my character. Fuck! Portal here on the other side. Sometimes the stages are a bit too small, so you can't really see where you are on the stage. I think they threw you to the left and they threw you to the right. Oh, I could. If I click down. Yeah, I can run to the right, but only if I harder for some reason. We'll need to configure that later. See if I somehow made a mistake there. Only 2 lives remaining. Mine right there. Fuck. 1 life. Now it's the master hand. I need to check this again, because I think might be an issue there. It's me clicking it slightly wrongly there. Let's try this. Easy to move to the left, but for some reason it has a hard time doing it to the right. It's not impossible, but it's a hard time doing it. Fuck. Click the wrong button. Okay, so this is my old favorite game. When I was 10 years old, this was certainly my favorite game. Now I can't even move to the right. Oh, but I can. Fuck that. I need to fix the controllers. They're perfect to the left, but to the right, for some reason, they are not perfect. I can't even do certain moves because it can't walk to the right anymore. So that's why I died there. Because it doesn't follow commands. I don't know. If I click right and up, like slightly upwards but right, then he runs. So that's good. He can easily run now. He can't walk. Thank you. does that attack instead of the attack that I wanted to do. He's not supposed to do that attack. He's supposed to do the upwards. That's the wrong attack. I don't know why. I could exit good. The controller's fucked up. I can't even move this controller. Fuck that. We'll have to... this one is no longer working. Okay, now it should work. So one of the buttons didn't work. It had no button assigned because I managed to somehow deactivate it when I changed the other one, so I couldn't move upwards. No wonder I lost it. Training mode, so I can jump. Easily run, as if you move to the left slightly, he will walk. And if I just a slight move to the left, he will run. Actually, that's really good. Right, he seems to walk instead, unfortunately. Downwards right is running. That's good. But I don't have to do it downwards when I do it to the left for some reason. Upwards left is a jump. Upwards right is a jump. Right is a jump. Right is walking, unfortunately. Downwards right is running. Left is running, but right is walking. Very hard to walk to the left, and hard to run to the right. See here. Straight to the right walking, straight to the left running. Downwards left. Left's downward. thought to do it. Wish it was just moving it to the right. Okay, we're done. It's not exactly like on the Nintendo 64. It's slightly more annoying to walk and run. Okay, to the right at least. Okay, remix modes. All-star mode, multi-man mode, cruel multi-man mode, and remix one player. We'll go for remix one player. And we'll play as Mewtwo. Okay. Let's start the game. We're fighting Wolf, evil guy from Starving, Violet Horse, on a new stage. Suitable for the character. Cool stage. It wasn't in the original game. It's completely new. The attacks by Mewtwo were similar to the ones in Melee and in the Brawl mods. So yes, the same attack. Probably some differences. Because this game, the original game, slightly different. It doesn't have as many features as the later game. I believe it lacked some buttons of the GameCube controller. Fuck. It was actually hard to use Mewtwo on this game stage. Because he can hardly hit him with the blast. I like his moveset. This. Fuck, he blockaded that attack. But we lost a life, so that's not good. Alright, the next stage, this stage was in Melee, I believe. The other one I didn't recognize, but this one I think is a recreation of the one in Melee. It's not the same. But it's a recreation to the old game, based on the Melee stage. I believe. Unless it's old. NES was in the old game after all, but I think this stage is from the second game. Just remade for the old game here. Okay. Mewtwo has some new attacks compared to in Melee. Couldn't spam like that in Melee. So I think he's slightly better in this game. At least you do not need to be a pro to be good with Mewtwo. He has some really cool attacks. Okay. I believe he was the strongest attack in Melee, but in Super Smash Bros. Melee, but for the GameCube, but you needed to be an advanced player to utilize all his moves. If you did, he was unstoppable. That's why they removed him from Brawl, I believe. Replaced him with Carrier, similar popular, less strong, and less popular. Okay. I like how his beam looks in this game. It looks much more powerful. Dark. When he hits with the beam, I believe it was stronger in the old game. Fuck, we lost again. Never cared much about Ness and Lucas. Never played their games, so I think they are from some old Nintendo games, probably Neo Geo or something. I don't know for sure. Never really cared. I used to play Donkey Kong, Super Mario, Pokemon, Zelda. As kids, I know these characters. They don't know Ness and his friends. And Samus Aran, I didn't know until I played Super Smash Brothers, actually. Captain Falcon, I didn't know either. I never played F-Zero for the Super Nintendo. So imagine this was a lightsaber, and almost imagine I was a Star Wars character using it, but it's not a lightsaber, it's slightly different. It's kind of a lightsaber, but it's not a Star Wars one. Anyway, I like that they included those swords when I was a kid, because I liked Star Wars too. It made me wish they had Star Wars characters in it. But actually, the mod Super Smash Bros. Universe, Super Smash Bros. Super Smash Bros. Brawl Universe has Star Wars characters in it. They're pretty good, but their own, like Victor Music and such. But fortunately, the game was very unstable. So I went through the entire selection screen over 200 characters, and then we were very excited because I really wanted to play it and enjoy it, and then I managed to play like one fight with four players fighting against each other, controlled by the AI, just enjoying watching the fight, and then when I enabled the team mode, the game just froze. I had to exit, and then I started it, and that time it worked, but a few seconds after selecting the fourth character, the game locked again, and I had to exit. So, unless I played like 1 versus 1, or AI versus, I believe, 4 versus 4, but no, what am I saying? I mean, unless I played 1 versus 1, or 4 players, but all free for all, then it would game work. So I couldn't play them in teams and such. We lost the game because the time ended. By the way, so this is Mewtwo in this game. He looks kinda like the Mewtwo from the Nintendo 64 game, but I don't believe it's the same model. It's inspired by that model, but and looks more aggressive like that one, but I believe Mewtwo looked less aggressive in the modern games, but and more hostile in the old ones, but this is not a direct copy of the 64 game. I believe the 64 game had a better model, to be honest. Better arms and a better face and such, but and a better body. It's very similar in style. Maybe they should have just ported it from the Pokemon Stadium game instead. I believe this one is remade in the old style. maybe had been a better idea to just use the 64 model, because it's similar but even better. Okay. I like his attacks, he's still a good model. Idea how they modified or hacked the files in order to enable new characters in the old game. It's quite a process to do that. It's not modding, it's hacking. They hack the original game. The video game, console game, had it been a computer game, it would have been modding. But when it's a console game, it's probably much more complicated to do and requires a lot of coding or hacking, as they say. They use some kind of hex editor to change numbers in the original log file. I have no idea how they added new characters and such. But it is a form of modding. Just more difficult than if it were a computer game. Okay. Yeah, Mewtwo was really good in this game. I actually think he has better moves in this game than in the official game. He has the same moves, but they are more powerful here, with the exception of his main beam. While it looks better, it's actually weaker when it hits the enemy. In melee, when you hit with that attack, the enemy will fly out of the ring or out of the stage. But in this game, it's not that powerful. However, the other attacks are more powerful here. Psychic attacks especially. You can still move the same, teleport and such. This is like a new game because this stage didn't exist. Lucas weren't in the game either. I believe I'm fighting different variations of Lucas. Fuck, he used the hammer. Super Mario hammer. You basically always lose when you're hit with that. Okay. Mewtwo was really good, I think. Okay. Felt better with him than with Link, despite Link being the character I was totally overpowered with in the past. Now it feels like Mewtwo would be that character. His attacks are just OP. Oh, that Lucas guy took a saw. Now I got one, so I'm bigger. Yeah, this model is pretty good and looks like this Pokemon Stadium one. I think the Stadium one is slightly more detailed, I might be wrong. Alright, we won. Versus Bowser. I like Bowser in melee as well. I didn't like that they made him smaller in Brawl. Thought it was more badass when it was bigger. You can strike with his tail. This is a new stage as well. I've never fought in this stage before. Really impressive stage. It's Bowser's stage. Fuck, he threw a bomb at me. One of those Super Mario bombs. Living bombs. So you're playing with the Nintendo 64 emulator. And therefore the graphics are better than in the original. It has the same models, but it has way better resolution. Oh fuck, that's the benefit of using emulators, that the graphics are always enhanced. Because the graphics of the emulators, first of all, the emulators allow you to use much better resolution that fits your computer screen. Then, if you have a good graphics card, you can also take advantage of that in the emulator to have maximum resolution. It's cool that Mewtwo doesn't hold the sword, and instead is using it with his psychic powers. Which makes sense. Die. Targets. Okay. He has the same stage, I believe, as someone else, probably. Similar one. Problem is knowing where you should go first. Mod is confusing, or hack, because it's named Super Smash REMIX something. There is a REMIX mod for Roll as well, for the Nintendo Wii. So I thought at first that they were speaking about the REMIX mod for Roll, but this one is completely different. Right. Wonder if there's. I believe we are allied with Link. No, it's everyone versus everyone. Maybe he is an ally, but we can still attack him. Fuck, the plane came and fired at us, of all things. It was the worst thing that could happen. Fuck that. Out of the way. Fuck. Fuck! Managed to take us out, we only had one life. Alright, continue. Yeah, it didn't go too well, because it was kinda hard. But I liked the new remix version. It's exciting to see the new stages and such. This stage is old, but the background is new, I believe. And the battle is new. The original story mode, you only fought Fox. Here you fight four others. Or three others, I mean. And two others. You're fighting Fox and two others. Making it more difficult. Challenging. There we got the perfect hit on Donkey Kong. Fuck, he destroyed my beam. If he hits me with a laser beam, I seem to lose my energy that I've gathered. Ah, he got taken out by that mine. Okay. Dark Samus. On a new stage, Rinstar Depths. Lee. Metroid. It's a stage from Billy, remade for this game, I see. I like the music. Dark Samus wasn't in Melee, as far as I remember. But Zero Suit Samus, where you see her hair and face and such. So Samus is a female. Fuck, we died. Fighting a giant version of Young Link. This stage was in Melee. It's been remade for the original game. Almost died. Link got himself killed. We were lucky. I almost got myself killed. Falling down into the water. Very lucky, like that. You'll probably lose now. Fuck that. red one. Fuck, I need that one. Destroy those things, maybe with the giant fire ball. I didn't have enough time to gather enough energy to try that. Okay. VS Marks, Kirby Superstar. Alright, another new stage. What the fuck? Couldn't jump. The controller didn't react when I clicked on the move up button. Again. Mewtwo isn't that good in melee unless you get that good attack. I don't always pull it off. It's harder. Only one life left, might lose here. This attack is really good. You can spam it forever. It's like a flamethrower. I like it. It's hard to pull off sometimes. Fuck. You only need one mistake like that. You lose sight of the character for a second and it's over. Really, really good hack of the original game, this one. It feels like the Super Smash Bros. 2 that we never got. I mean, really, it was kind of the new one. But and they take a lot of damage, these guys. But anyway, this hack feels like the Super Smash Bros. 2 that we never got for the Nintendo 64. The second game was for the Nintendo GameCube, as I've said. The third game for the Nintendo Wii. Then the fourth game for the Wii U, and the fifth game for the Nintendo Switch. I only had the first three games, and I plan on buying a Switch in the future. I really like they've added some of the characters there. Unlike in a mod, it's actually stable, it won't crash and such, and also Sephiroth looked way better in the official game than he did in the mod. I believe in the mod he used the same look as in Final Fantasy Dissidia. I never liked his haircut there. Well, in the official Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game for the Nintendo Switch, he looks exactly like his anime look from the original game, the look I always loved and preferred. And I were always disappointed they didn't keep that look in Dissidia and the Crisis Core. So, of course, I prefer his look in the official game. And the official game has a lot of other characters too that are impressive. But I don't want to spend too much money on a console for one game. I don't really need to have this game to play and then have many other games that aren't Smash Brothers to play, and I have a bunch of mods for the Nintendo Wii to play. And also I do not have a problem with the Wii game, and this game is that I don't have many people to play with, so I play against the computer. If I get the Nintendo Switch game, I can play online, because it's online compatible. I believe the Wii mods can be played online if you play on the Dolphin emulator. So that's an option, but then I don't have the Nintendo GameCube controller because I do not have any adapter for it. But if I got an adapter for it, so I could use the controllers on the computer, then yeah, I could play it online. But with the Switch, of course, you can play online, so that's without having to get adapters for the controllers and such. That's the benefit of having the recent game. I believe the Brawl from the game for Nintendo Wii was online compatible in the past, but unfortunately the servers went down in 2014. I remember playing Brawl online in 2008 or something. But yeah, the servers went down. So now it's impossible unless you use the emulator through the computer. So we lost again, let's continue. I want to see what the boss is like. We have 4 stages remaining, I see. We need to defeat these guys. We're playing on normal difficulty. Not hard and not very hard, but it's still hard. We didn't want to play an easy or very easy. But obviously hard and very hard is far beyond my level currently. These guys take a lot of damage each hit. They can hit you when you stand on those platforms from below. Very annoying. Need to be very offensive here. And I still have the problem, I can't really move to the right. Rarely does when I want to. Attack is very stable, unlike that Super Smash Bros. Brawl universe mod that crashed all the time in the selection screen when you clicked on Team Battle. Very annoying when that happens and you have to restart the console and such. If this game crashed, it wouldn't be as bad because it's a emulator game, so you would just have to restart the program in the computer. But the Wii, it's annoying because you need to restart the entire console. It's not just clicking on a button, it's restarting it, then going into the homebrew channel, and then loading up the game. It takes forever, and when that's done, it happens again. Very frustrating. So, this is a really difficult stage for me, at least. Might not be able to win here. Unless I use cover tactics, spam. And we got huge. Look at the guy and Mewtwo here. Almost too big for the stage. Just spam both of them, we killed both. Perfect. Fuck! Fuck! Fuck, I wanted that hammer. Lost again. I guess we will have to give up. Maybe we'll try one more time. So the Remix story mode is much more difficult than the original one. Fail at this stage each time. You take a lot of damage when they hit, and they can hit you when you stand on the platforms. And you can hardly hit them with Mewtwo because they are melee. You are not. You prefer being at a distance while they prefer being close. Also, the controller has problems in running to the right and doing attacks to the right. That require running. The main problem is that they take a lot of damages in shield. Make me fly like that. Like 3 hits, I'm dead. Or 4. Even though normal hits like that. They are almost cheating. Fuck! I wanted that bomb, but it started to move. I have 1 life again. Fuck, I used the flamethrower before I could fire him. I'm really impressed with this hack for the original game. It's like the Super Smash Bros. 2 for the Nintendo 64 that you never got. That the similar project for the Brawl game that aims to turn Brawl into Super Smash Bros. For the Nintendo 64, but with new characters and such, while still keeping them to characters that existed in 1999 and keeping the old features and such. I believe that game, that mod will be similar to this one. probably will allow more stages and more characters and than in this version. But I don't know in what way it will be that much different or better. Maybe it will have more alternative skins too.
Game over.
We took too long to decide what to do, so we got game over. Alright, I think this will be it. So this is Smash Remix for the Project 64 emulator. Okay, thanks for watching, and maybe we'll play more later. See ya.